गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डू फ्यू इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ चैप्टर 16. वी विल डू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 16.3 एंड मिसेलेनियस एक्सरसाइज. चैप्टर 16 प्रोबेबिलिटी. We'll do few important questions from exercise 16.3. Let's start. Question number 7. Read the statement. A fair coin is tossed 4 times and a person wins rupees 1 and lose rupees 150, 1 rupees 50 paisa for each tail that turns up. From the sample space, calculate how many different amount of money you can have after 4 tosses and the probability of having each of these amounts. As you know, when you toss a coin 4 times, here I am just telling you first of all how to get the sample space when you toss the coin 4 times. Suppose here is a coin, you tossed once, you will get head and tail. Now, if it further tossed, it means again you are getting head and tail. This is a tree of tossing a coin. Now, again, if third time you are tossing coin, it means it is again head and tail. Like this, make the tree like this. Now, it tossed 4 times, it means again 4 H and T. This is H and T. It is also H and T. Now you have to write the elements which you will get. I will tell you how to write. This is H, 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 H. It means second one, for first case is all our heads. Second one, H, H, H and tail. Then H, H, T and T. H, H, T, T. It means every branch gives you 2 cases. Every branch gives you 2 cases. 2, 2, 2, 2 cases. How many are here? 2 to 4. We are getting 16 cases. Total cases you will get 16. Now you can, I think, observe here. If I take the last one, that is T, 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 and T. And T, T, H. Sorry, T, 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 H. This one. It means you can now frame number of cases after tossing the coin 4 times. Now, here is a question. When you toss a coin and a person wins 1 rupee when head is there. If head is there and lose 1.50 for each tail, that turns up. Okay, it means in the first case, let's take the first case, when no head, and no head means all tails are there, all tails. It means 4 tails are there. If 4 tails are there, or you can say 4 tail appears. Okay. Now money on 1 tail, we are losing 1.50. So on 4 tails, it means what? We are losing 4 into 1.5, or you can say you will lose 6 rupees. Okay. Now, when I want to calculate the probability for that, in this case, probability of getting no head, and it means 4 tails. will be equal to what? How many cases are there? Only one case is there. You can count here. Only one case is there. Favorable case is 1 and total cases are 16 when you are losing 6 rupees. These two cases are in a one case. Now, second part. See, in a second case, when one head is there, one head means along with this one head, you will get 3 tails appear. Now, about the money, you will get 1 rupees and lose 3 multiplied by 1.50. It means you will get how many? 1 you are losing, and after money you lost is equal to how much money you will lost. It will be rupees 3.50. For head it is 1 rupees, and for tail this you are gaining, or this is you are losing when you are calculating it, is 1.50, so 3050. Okay, now this is because what? Minus 1 into 1 plus 3 into 1.50, and you are getting loss of rupees 3.50. Now, third part, before we go for third part, probability we have to calculate. Probability of the required part will be equal to how many cases will be there when one head and 3 tails are there. You will get 4 cases, and favorable case is 4 and total case will be 16. It comes out equal to 1 upon 4. And third part, when 2 head and 2 tails appear. What you have to calculate first? Money gain or loss. Money. Here again you lost some money. Money lost is equal to how much money you lost? Rupees 1. How you are calculating? 2 multiplied 1.5 minus 1 into 2, you are getting loss of rupees 1. And probability of the third part, how many cases will be there where 2 heads and 2 tails are there? 6 cases will be there. It means 6 upon 16, and simplify it, 3 upon 8. Now, next part, when 3 heads and 1 tail is there. 3 heads, fourth part. When 3 head and 1 tail appear. So the money here, gain will be there. Money gain means 3 into 1. Minus 1 into 1.5, you are getting, that comes out equal to 3 and minus 1.5 rupees, gaining of 1.5. and fifth part, sorry, probability of fourth part you have to calculate first. Probability will be what? 3 heads, 1 tail. How many cases will be there here? 4 cases will be there. You can count on the first base. It is written 1 upon 4 probability. When all the head appears, so means money gain will be there. If you are getting head, you are getting gain. It means four heads are there. Money gain will be 4 rupees. After getting one head, you are getting 1 rupees. So 4 rupees gain is there. Probability of all heads, it means only one case will be there. That will be 1 upon 16. This is a question 7th. Now come to the question number next one. Which one we will do? Question number 10. In a lottery, a person chooses 6 different natural numbers at random from 1 to 20. And if these 6 numbers match with the 6 numbers already fixed by the lottery committee, he wins the prize. What is the probability of winning the prize in the game? Here the question is, out of 20, you have to pick 6 different numbers. One number is a fixed number, which is for the prize, to getting the prize or to win the prize. So first of all, how many numbers we can frame after choosing 6 numbers from the 20 numbers? And only one number is there which will give you a prize. It means favorable cases will be only 1. And total cases will be, out of 20, you are getting 6 numbers. It means favorable cases will be question number 11. Total cases which you will get out of 20, you are choosing 6. I think you can apply the formula 20, factorial 20, factorial 6, factorial 14. Now simplify it, you are getting a number that is 38760. Favorable cases, only one ticket is there on which you will get the prize. Only one is the case there. So probability required is, one is a favorable case and total cases are 38760. This is the answer. Now come to the question number 20. Question number 20. The probability that a student will pass the final examination in both English and Hindi. English means we are taking E, and for Hindi we are taking H. Okay. Both means what is given? Probability of E intersection H is given to you. Both means intersection. And the probability of getting passing neither. Neither means he is not passed the English or Hindi both. Probability of neither E intersection, E complement intersection, H complement is given 0.1. Next one, if the probability of passing the English exam, is 0.75. It means probability of, this is what? Probability of passing English exam is 0.75. What is the probability of passing Hindi exam? It means we want to calculate probability of passing Hindi exam. Now question is, we have to apply the question of, first we have done, okay, we have to apply the formula. Probability of E union H, that is probability of E plus probability of H minus probability of E intersection H. Now, E intersection is known to you. E is known to you. If you want to find out this H, you have to find out first this one, probability of E union H. How you can find it? We can find, let's draw here. Probability of what you know about, E complement, intersection H complement, you know that is 0.1. As by using the De Morgan's law, it is what? E union H whole complement. And this can be written as 1 minus probability of E union H, like this. Now 1 minus 0.1 will be probability of E union H. 1 minus 0.1 means this is 0.9 probability of E union H. Now put the values. This is 0.9. Probability of E is, I think, 0.75 we have written. This we have to calculate in the, and intersection is 0.5. Now question is, the probability of Hindi will be calculated 0.9 minus 0.75 plus 0.5. Simplify it. These two have, you have to add 1.4 minus 0.75. Probability of Hindi 1.4 minus 0.75, we are getting 0.65. This is the probability of getting Hindi. This is a question number 20. Now question, other questions you have to try your own. Now come to the miscellaneous exercise. We will do question number 6 of miscellaneous exercise. Question number 6, now exercise, miscellaneous exercise. Question number 6. Now, three letters are dictated to three persons and an envelope is addressed to each of them. The letters are inserted into the envelopes at random so that each envelope contains exactly one letter. Find the probability that at least one letter is in its proper envelope. Here three letters and three envelopes are there. How many ways are there, total ways, to put the letter in the envelope? Total ways will be 3 factorial, because three letters are there and three envelopes are there. They can be arranged in a 3 factorial ways. It means that is 6 ways are there. Now favorable cases. For favorable cases, here the condition is given, at least one letter should be in a proper envelope. One letter is in its proper envelope. Now suppose here, for the favorable cases, suppose here are L1, L2, L3, three letters. And these are the E1, E2, E3 envelopes. Now suppose L1 is on the right place and L2 and L3 are interchanged. First case, suppose L2 is on the right place and L3 and L1 interchange their places. Suppose L3 on right place and these two are interchanged. These are the three cases when the at least one letter, kam se kam ek aur jyada se jyada teeno, greater than equal to one, at least means one. So for the two, suppose L1 is on the right place, L2 is on the right place, automatically L3 will go in a right place. So other, if you take L2 and L3 are on the right place, L1 will go to the right place. It means this is the case which is common for three. It means total favorable cases will be equal to 4. So probability required will be equal to favorable cases upon total cases. This will be 2/3. Now we will discuss now question number 9. Question number 9 we will discuss. If 4 digit numbers greater than 5000 are randomly formed from the digits are 0, 1, 3, 5 and 7, what is the probability of forming a number divisible by 5 when the digits may repeat or may not repeat? here are two cases. First case is when digits are repeating, are repeated or repeating. If the digits are repeating or you are forming a four digit number greater than 5000. Okay, now if you are forming and the digits are repeated, number greater than 5000, it means what? For total cases you will fix 5 first, then there are 3 places. You will fix 7 first, then 3 places. And repetition is there. It means these are 2 fixed places, ways. These are fixed. Now how many letters are there to put here? 5 are there, which can be maybe 0, maybe 1, maybe 3, maybe 5, maybe 7. Will be put here on the place here. So 125 here, total cases will be 250. Now for the repetition, favorable cases, for favorable cases, repetition is there and the number should be divisible by 5. If any number which is divisible by 5, it means its end will be by the number 5 or 0. So two numbers are fixed in the first place, 5, these are fixed. If ends with 0, if ends with 5. And here 7 and 7. And here 0 or maybe here 5. Because repetition is there, that's why we have taken this case, 5-5 case. Now, this is the end place and this is the first place, which is fixed. Now, here are two places which you have to fill. Repetition is there. So, here may be the chances of the letter which can be written are 5 into 5. So how many ways are there? 25 fours are 100. 25 first, 25 second, 25. Probability of first part will be, when the repetition is there, 100 upon 250. That will be equal to 2 upon 5. This is the first case. Now for the second case, when the repetition is not allowed. When the repetition is, when digits are not repeated, if the repetition is not allowed, first we have to calculate total cases. The total cases, number should be greater than what? 5000. Number greater than 5000 means here we have to take, when we fix 5 here, here are 3 places which you fill. Here if you fix 7, here if the repetition is not allowed, it means one letter is used here, 5 and 7 in the place. Now other 3 places can be filled by taking the 4, 3 and 2. It means 24, 4, 3 and 2. 24 total cases will be 48. For favorable cases, number should be divisible by 5. Here I have told you 5 is fixed, 0 is should be the end. And if 5 is here and here you will take 5, repetition comes, so it, leave it, take 7 and end with 0, 7 end with 5. These are the cases which you have to take. These are the end digits. and these are the first digit. Now here you have to fill two places when the repetition is not allowed. Two digit already used out of two. You have used out of sorry five. You have used two digits. Three are left here. So number of favorable cases will be 3 into 2, 3 into 2, 3 into 2. 6 threes are 18. Total 18 cases. So probability of the second part will be equal to 18 upon 48. That will be equal to 3 upon 8. This is the answer of the second question. Now you have to complete the questions of exercise 16.3 and miscellaneous exercise. Do all the questions. Thank you. Have a nice day.